Hello friends, this is Red Dice Lunar. I'm going to show you how to get the most valuable resources from Bahari Bay, in my opinion, using what I call the storm run. So this run is not something for fast leveling your skills or get anything specific in large amount. I can make other videos for this, so put a comment if you want me to make any information. So I always get some food and I always fish. I always fish with Fishman's Brew with this, and I get some Dispel arrows, some fine arrows. You can get standard arrows if you want, glowworms. I don't use any other worms, and the smoke bombs. I guess if you don't have glowworms, you can use regular ones or even not bait. So let's head over to Bahar Bay. Okay, so we start. In this area, I always check for white chapas because it's a white chapa spawn area. And as you will see, I will also get any iron ores. Here is a Brer Daisy. Because I have so many, I won't get it because I don't need any anymore. But you should. So I find an iron ore node. I only take the mediums and the large ones because if I'm lucky I will get the gold ore. So with the gold ore I would make gold bars and then oh, here is a bug. These bugs I always get them, that's why I have the smoke bombs with me. They spawn only for the from the stones, either regular or quality. This is quality. I get them because of the silk threads, and they give a little XP for the bug catching skill. So yeah, as I was saying, I make honey lures with the gold bars. That's because the honey lures for me is the best way to get some epic bugs, regular and star qualities. Mostly star qualities. I guess you can try and go around, but it would be so hard. So here's the first Palium spot. Because it's a Palium, it's a Palium spot, we get everything, we mine everything, so we can help the spawn rate of the Paliums. So even if there were like small nodes of stone, I would still get them. Yeah, we keep mining. Oh, we actually see there's too small. I usually don't call in the chat for any Palium because it will mess up my time, but I always check behind me when I mine them. So if I see someone coming, I will stop so I will, so he or she can get it. Here we see another one. So we mine it and we will, right now we will head over to the next cave. This is the path I'm taking usually. Because there are iron nodes here. Okay, we check behind, there's nothing, so we drop down here. Again, this is the second pallium spot, so we mine everything here. Sometimes there would be nothing inside the pallium spots. You can actually wait for I usually wait for like 30 seconds to see if someone's spawning. Here, however, I check the things to see if there's brides from spawning. Nothing. So what I was saying is that if there's nothing in the pallium spots, I wait to see if someone is spawning, but then I leave. If there's nothing, this usually means another guy or somebody went there firstly. So now we go down underground, and this is another pallium spot here, so we get everything again. We see a small one again. Take it here, it spawns here too, so we get this. And now we will use the geyser. So, with the geyser, at first I check the hill like in the right of me, and I see some nodes. So, I go get them. If there's no nodes here, I will show you afterwards where I'm going. So now we take this big iron here too. And there is a branch room up ahead, so I will head over to take it. The bride's rooms are used. I use them for Dispellarus. Okay, I think they're used in some cooking recipes too, but I need them for the Dispellarus because I use the Dispellarus to hunt the wet chapas and the magic deers. I guess you can hunt them without them, but I prefer to do it with them, so it's faster. Okay, there's another big iron on here. So now I will head over right now to the cave again, the underground one, to show you where I'm going with the geyser if I don't see anything in the hill. So yeah, the same thing. Okay. So, if I don't see anything on the cave, I head over to the beach. The reason why I'm heading over to the beach is for a chance to get dragon beads. The dragon beads is an item that looks like the Emerald Moss item. A green. It's more to a green blue thing in the ground. We will see it when I get one. And the reason why I'm farming them is again for the honey lures. It's an item for in the honey lure recipe again with the gold bar. And the same as pallium, it has specific spawn locations. Some are up ahead. There's nothing here. So another spawn location is up this cliff. It's like here. There's nothing. There's another one. Yeah, here it is one. This is Dragon Bird's Bait. Okay. There are two more spawn locations here on the left of me, on those cliffs. But there's nothing here right now, so we go. Oh no, we see a fishing spot here in a bit, so we take the fishing brew, the go our gold worm, and we fish it up. Meanwhile, while I'm doing this, I always check the chat if someone shouts for like berry gloves or hairdrop lilies or flow trees, and if I'm near them, I go and take them. Let's see what we will fish. Okay. No epic fish. So yeah, I'm heading right now to the other side of the beach. To this side, I'm trying to stick next to the water to see if there is any fish hotspots spawning. And there is another dragon bead spawn point up ahead. Let's see. Okay, here it is. And now, when I turn left here in this river, and I take this path. Excuse me. If I see any sweet leaf, I take it. And now I will check the ruins here on my left. If a branch room has spawned. And next, I'm heading over to the geyser near the Bahari Centrals. And I always check around here. This is white deer spawn point. So yeah, I'm heading over here to the geyser. This is actually another Pallium spawn point, so we get everything. And then we get the geyser. And now, with this path, we will head over to the cave near Tamala's house. But you always have to go from the right side to get the white Sernook spawn points. So here is one. So what I'm doing, I hit it first with the dispel, then I change fast with iron arrows. Okay, so this one someone has hit it before. If it was freshly spawned, it would take 6 hits, and it does not matter which arrow you use because I guess it's bugged, and all the arrows are doing the same damage. Now, before I head over to the Tamala's cave, I usually check the river here for fish hotspots points. They are known, so we head over down. Here is another Pallium spot, so again, we take everything. Oops. And always remember the food, the focus. Okay, that was an arrow flying in my screen. Okay, now we will head over to the flooded fortress. But in meanwhile, in this path, we will check again for magic tears because this is another spawn point. We will check for sweet leaves. We will check for iron ores and flow wood. There's only a sweet leaf. And so here in the fortress, we check the north here area in the cliff. There's a polymorph, and I see a big one here. But first, we take the regular stone to help with the spawn. And now we take the big one. We check behind if someone is coming. We will stop. No, so we take it. Right now, I go down because I check if there's hot spots here in the river or find bar crabs or snails. I don't remember this name lane, the snail's name. You could go faster from upwards to the next point I'm going. Yeah, I need the fishing spots. So we see two here. No crabs though. Okay, again, this specific fishing spot, it's sometimes bugged. While it shows you that you fish in it, you don't, and you end up fishing regular fish. Let's see. Oh, yeah, that's what happens here. Here, that's the first bug. The second bug is if you fish right now, there's two chances. The one chance is that you will get the same fish that you have we got right now, but quality, and the fishing pot will disappear. The second one is that we'll get another regular, so the fishing spot it's not here at all, even if it's showing in the screen. What? Okay, so that's the second bug. This is still regular. So we leave this fishing spot and we go to the second one. That's a treasure chest. Okay. What we get? I have it already. I find it bad that it can give me the same thing multiple times. Okay, so now we climb here and we go to another pallium spot here in the south cliff of fortress. We start from here and we go. Okay. Oh, so we have two medium here. We check from behind to see if someone is coming. We will stop. No one's coming. Who we take them? And we have another two here. Oh, three actually. It's a big one too. We get the bug too, so we take the bugs. Okay. Again, we check for the irons. It's a big one here. And now we will head over inside the Pavel mines. Here's another Pavel spot, so we take this stone and the stone up our head. And here at first we will check the area here for fishing spots. So here is one, so Fishman Brew and fish. Every fishing hotspot we're doing has a chance to give us an epic fish. Only the one at the beach, you can have the unicorn fish only at day. But this year it has a chance for the Void Ray, and the others we did had a chance for an eel. I don't remember the eel's name, but it's an epic one. So here's another iron. Now we will head outside. And we will take the geyser. I would go at top. Oh, here's another iron, so we take these two. Now we will climb from here. And we will be on top of the Pavel mines. But let's get the iron ores at first. I see here. Okay, now we will head over inside. Another pallium spot, so we mine everything. And I see a small one, so we check behind if someone's coming. Okay, no. So, and we drop down here. That's because that's another pallium spot, so we take everything. Again, drop one level down, same thing. There were actually one small. And here at the last level. Okay, there's a bug, so we take them. The crabs and the snails in the fortress give silk threads too. And we were a bit unlucky because we didn't get any gold ores. So again, we take this geyser. And this geyser is bugged, so it needs water. Water it so it can shoot you up again. And now we check here on the left of the screen, there's another white Chapa spawn point. There's none here though, so we head over to the portal. Oh, I see an iron. Maybe gold ore. No. Okay. It's pretty rare. Drop from the iron. And now we take the portal and we head over to the Highway Bluffs. You can fish in this pond too behind me, but I don't want to any other goldfish, so I don't. So right now we are here at the starting point, and what I do is usually go and do this circle until 6 a.m. Here, okay, there's another. Okay. So yeah, that was it. I usually do it at 6 a.m. because I want to max the inner's romance and of course my gardens. But you can do it until your bags is full, whatever you want. So this is the run. Thank you very much for watching. We got some things here. The amount of things you get depends. Maybe I would get them more or less each run. Yeah. But we didn't get any, what's called, which. Where is it? Oh yeah, white Chapa. White Chapa tail, this is the antlers are bugged, so you don't get the star quality antlers, but you can get the quality tail. I can show you in another video in easy way if you want. So that was the video. Again, thank you. Like and subscribe if you want, and I would be very happy to answer any question you have about the game. You can comment down below or even make a video for your questions. Maybe I would show you some spawn points for anything you like to find, and I know, or quests or whatever.